Hey, my friends, there is an incredible story in Luke chapter 18. It's in verses 35 through 43. And it's a story of a man who encounters Jesus, and it changes everything. And I want to read it to you. It starts like this. Jesus is nearing the city of Jericho. A blind man is sitting there begging by the roadside. He can hear the sounds of the crowd accompanying Jesus, and he asks, "What's going on?" The crowd says to him, "Jesus of Nazareth is passing this way." Then the man starts shouting. He's shouting, "Jesus, son of King David, show mercy to me." The people in the front of the crowd reprimand him and tell him to be quiet, but he just shouts louder, and he's shouting, "Son of King David, show mercy to me." Jesus stops, and he tells the people to bring the man over to him. The man stands in front of Jesus, and Jesus asks him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man says, "Lord, let me receive my sight." Jesus says, "Receive your sight, your faith has made you well." At that very instant, the man is able to see. He begins following Jesus, shouting praises to God. And everyone in the crowd, when they see what has happened, starts praising God too. Okay, here's a blind beggar. He sits by the roadside all day long. That's what he's been doing for years, probably his entire life. And he just begs for money. And he... in the meantime, has heard a lot of things, because that's what he does. He just sits there. People walk by. He overhears a lot. And in the course of his life, he has overheard a whole lot of things. And right now, he hears the crowd, and he hears a lot of noise, and he hears a lot of excitement, and he's like, "Hey, what's going on?" And they're like, "Jesus is passing this way." Now, he's heard the buzz about Jesus, and as he has heard the buzz about Jesus, something has grown inside of him. Faith has grown inside of him. Romans 10:17 says this, that faith comes from hearing the good news about Jesus. And he's heard a lot of people talking about Jesus as he sat there by the roadside. He couldn't see them, but he could hear them. And he's overheard this, and he has overheard the news about Jesus. Faith has grown inside of him. So he cries out for Jesus. He cries out for help, and Jesus hears him. And just the way that he cries out shows us his faith, because he's like, "Jesus, son of King David." So he's basically saying, "Jesus, I believe that you are the chosen one. I believe that you are the Messiah. I believe that you are the one that we've been waiting for." So he's kind of putting his faith on demonstration just by what he is shouting out. And Jesus hears him. And then Jesus asks him a pretty obvious question. "What do you want me to do for you?" Jesus has him brought over to him. Jesus can see that the dude can't see. But he's like, "What do you want me to do for you?" "Hello, Captain Obvious." Jesus could hear his faith, but Jesus also wanted to hear his heart. He wanted him to define his dependence. When we come to Jesus, we need to define our dependence. We need to humble ourselves. We need to admit our need. We need to ask for help. We need to, if we act like we've got it all together and we don't need any help, then he can't do much for us. But if we come to him humbly and just say, "Man, I have messed up. I've jacked up my life and I need your help. I need you to help me see." And that's what happens. So Jesus tells the guy, "Your faith has made you well." Then at that very instant, he is able to see. And he turns around, he follows Jesus, he starts shouting praises to God. Now, that's the obvious reaction for us too. When I see who Jesus is, I need to follow him and I need to shout praises along the way. I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. So I need to follow him. I need to shout praises along the way. God bless you guys. Giddy up!